Ramchandra Guha, author, historian, columnist, and also a cricket fanatic, the author most recently of yet another book on the cricketing commonwealth. Thank you, Ram Guha, for joining me. Ram, there was so much to unpack from this series and from what happened today that one doesn't quite know where to start. What would you like to begin with as the most significant strand of this amazing moment?
I think it's testimony to the greatness of Test cricket. You know, the subtitle of my book calls cricket the most subtle and sophisticated game known to humankind.
Yes.
And Test cricket is far more subtle and sophisticated than T20 or One Day cricket. This last Test match that ended today, the previous one at Sydney, which showed the great drama of the draw. You know, people think it's always win or lose.
Yes.
But here we were on the last day against our backs and the way Ashwin and Bihari played, for example. Now, so, you know, this Test series, Vasu, will be discussed 30 or 40 years from now. People who are in their 20s will be reminiscing about it when they are senior citizens. Whereas the last IPL final played 2 months ago has already been forgotten.
Yes.
So what this series as a whole is, forget who won. It's about Test cricket as the most gorgeous form of the game, where you showcase all your diverse skills, which has the drama of a great epic. You know, it's like a Ramayana in 57 parts, with people with many different characters, playing many different kinds of roles, and having a chance to redeem themselves. In One Day cricket, you get out, you don't get a second chance. A bowler bowls 3 overs and that's the end of him. Whereas here, players get a chance to redeem themselves. So that's the first thing. The second thing is, this is a greater victory than what we achieved in Australia 3 years ago, 2.5 years ago, because Australia was at full strength and we were not. In this last match, in the last 3 matches, we did not have our best batsman and skipper. And in this match, we didn't even have our 3 best bowlers, Bumrah, Ashwin and Shabi.
Yes.
So, and also it's a testimony to quiet leadership. You know, you don't need a superstar to lead a team. You know, and maybe there's some lessons here for Indian politics as well.
Yes, there is, as I said, a lot to unpack here. And as you put it, in your book, a lifelong love affair that you've had with the most subtle and sophisticated game known to humankind, and certainly this series would bolster that case. But when you kind of run down, you know, T20, and I think you perhaps are a little more charitable with One Day, but when you run down T20, there is a case to be made that a lot of the ways in which our players played, especially this younger lot, the fearlessness, the confidence, the innovative batting came from T20.
I think the fearlessness. No, well, I think the most important thing about this team, compared to the teams that won in the past, is that it has players from all over India. You know, when I was growing up in the 1970s, it was all Bombay. Then it became all Bangalore. Here you have cricketers from all 4 corners of the land. And of course, the young are fearless. And I don't think that's really so much about T20 as about the churning in Indian society over the last 3 decades, where individual assertion has come to the fore in entrepreneurship, in creativity, and in so many other fields. So, you know, no, of course, some of the skills come from One Day cricket, particularly running between the wickets and fielding. But the way to, you know, the ability to shape your game to a Test match, Rishabh Pant was, I'm told, I don't watch the IPL, I'm told a failure in the IPL. But he adapted his game to Test cricket. Look at the way Rohit Sharma has adapted. So Test cricket is a different game altogether. You know, it's like, and it's just far more pleasurable. I was delighted to hear on the television that 60 million people watched the last day's play. Now, it's possible that 600 million people watched the IPL. But that experience is ephemeral. It's fleeting. It's forgotten the next day. Whereas this experience is like a great concert, a great Shakespearean play with great actors. It stays with you for life.
Right. It's like a Russian novel, like somebody put it. I think it was the cricket writer Rohit Brijnath.
In fact, I'm reading War and Peace at the moment. You know, and that's appropriate.
Is there, I know time is short. is there any, okay, name one player and then one moment that stood out for you in the series?
You see, in test cricket, you cannot do that. You know, Washington Sundar coming in for his first test and batting so bravely.
Right.
You know, Ashwin, whose batting has fallen off for so long, you know, doing what he did. Siraj,
right.
Cummins on the other side. Stark and Lyon. We won this test match and this series partly because Australia underperformed.
Right.
But while his colleagues were underperforming, there was the lion-hearted Cummins. So test cricket is not about 1-6, one event, one. It's a panoply of events and you have to celebrate all of them.
Okay. Very, very quickly, literally like a yes or no answer, is this the greatest series, India's greatest series ever?
Quite likely. Quite likely. I would still say 1971, when we beat England in England, when they were the best team in the world, is a close competitor. So that 1971 and 2021.
All right. Thanks very much, indeed, Ram. Yeah. Thank you very much, indeed, Ram Guha.